My name is Ken Moench. I was born in Glendale, Arizona. I lived there for a total of 6 months, and then we moved all over the country. My dad was in the military. I moved here about 30 years ago into the Austin area. I know that because my son's 30. He wasn't quite born yet. I became a massage therapist really by accident. I had no intention of ever going to massage school. I didn't even know there was such a thing as massage school. When I first started my career in healthcare, I thought I wanted to be a physical therapist. And the University of Texas was only offering the three classes I needed to finish my prereqs in the middle of the workday. And I was already married and had two kids, and there was no way I could take those classes. So massage therapy was a way to actually get my schedule worked out so that I could finish the classwork. When I got done with massage school, and I was still working at St. David's doing work in physical therapy clinic as a massage therapy aide, they let me start working on people as a massage therapist. And the weird part was I was fixing people that the physical therapist couldn't. And I was doing it really quickly. Like within one or two sessions, they were better, like pain-free. And I had a decision to make. Was I gonna continue going to school to learn how not to fix people, or was I gonna just go keep fixing people? And that's not casting aspersions on anything that physical therapists do. They do great work, but I feel fortunate that I didn't go into that aspect of it because I wasn't trained inside that box. So everything that I've done since then has been really outside the box. It was outside the physical therapy box. It was outside the massage therapy box, because my goal wasn't massage therapy. It was something that was kind of a mix, because it was just about trying to figure out the very best and fastest way to fix people. That was my goal. And I knew that if I just followed the, here's what these people did, then I could do that and do some version of that, or I could do what somebody else wrote in their book. But the only way that I could get better and actually fix people faster was to combine what several different thoughts were on how to, and methods to treat people. When I'm describing what we do, it really is a combination of different forms of treatment. It's myofascial release, trigger point therapy, deep tissue massage, combined with ranges of motion in targeted areas. But it's really, you know, we've talked about this quite a bit, and it's a lot more than that. It's a lot more than just the treatment. The treatment works. It's the reason why people come here from all over the countries. We've had people travel here from outside of the country. Which is insane to me. I don't like driving to Bastrop and back. But it's listening to what our clients have to say. Because I can find out in 5 minutes, usually, what's wrong with somebody just by listening to them. And it's something that they all say that they're just not listened to. And it's powerful in that we connect with our clients when we just listen. And it's not to confirm what we already think we know, it's actually learning about what their habits are and what they've done and the treatments that they've gotten, so that we can actually picture what's going on with them so that we know how to fix them. And then following through on that promise, because that's what people do come here, and I know other people have said this, but people come here, this is their last hope. And I can't go into specifics about different cases, but I mean, I had a guy that literally he told me after the second or third session that he planned on putting the pistol in his mouth and taking his life if I hadn't been able to help him the first time. And so people come here, so they sometimes are the very last hope. They've tried everything else, and the technique, just the physical technique works. It just does. It's very simple. It's direct. It works on plantar fasciitis to migraine headaches. But it's applying it thoughtfully to the client as though they're one of your loved ones. And the truth is, they all are anyway, because we come to love these people and because we care about them. None of my staff would be here. I wouldn't be here if I didn't care about helping people. And it's the most satisfying, wonderful blessing to be able to do this for a living. I can't imagine doing anything else. The reason I love doing this is because we see people walk in the door who have no hope that anything is ever going to change. They walk into a doctor's office and they get a script for more pills, or they have somebody telling them they need surgery. And they've done many times all of those things, and they've only gotten worse. They've gotten more and more and more pain over the years. And when you explain what you're going to do and how it works, and then they get off the table and it actually worked, and they stand up sometimes for the first time in years without any pain, what you've given them isn't just a pain-free day, you've given them hope for a pain-free life. And we follow through on that. And that's why we focus on people's, their nutrition and their hydration and their posture and their warm-ups and their cool-downs and their workouts and their, people are whole human beings. They're not just a body part that's injured. They're not a knee or a hip or an ankle. They're a whole person that needs to be tended to. And it's many times, it's their heart is hurting as much as anything else because they're so discouraged by the lack of attention to their real problems. And it's cool to be able to help people on that deep level.